So, can you believe it? Season one is kind of come to a wrap after we interview Harris Lee Rose.
It's like crazy. Did you send Harris his questions?
Yes, I did. I already sent him the questions, perfect. So he has those. He's looking them over.
Okay, perfect. I mean, I'm super excited about this. I can't, you know, wait to ask him about the fact that, you know, he did his exhibition in London just after 3 months.
I know, after 3 months of painting, he right. gets a show in London, which is kind of unheard of.
And the most exciting part about this episode is we finally get to do it the way we've always envisioned.
Yeah.
You know, so we'll still have the audio, but we are going to transition more to video, moving on to season two.
Also, video is better for us because we're going to visually represent these artists.
I just can't believe we're done with season one.
I can't believe that. Yeah. We are actually done with season one.
I know.
Oh, yeah. Whole world. MCs. Who slick.
I'm Josh.
And I'm Shay.
And today we have a great artist with us, Harris Lee Rose. We've kind of switched up our format a little bit. We kind of envisioned this as a podcast, but telling our stories and telling the artist stories, I think we decided that they needed a little more visual representation. So we kind of switched to video.
Yeah, but we still have audio on Spotify for those who want to listen to our show while they're driving or doing whatever. So with that said, our guest this week is an artist from New Jersey. His name is Harris Lee Rose, and he was gracious enough to take us into his studio. We kind of self-invited ourselves. Then we kidnapped him and brought him to NYC.
In a cabin in Soho.
In a cabin in Soho. Yes.
So with that said, meet Harris Lee Rose.
Hello. Thank you guys for having me.
Of course.
Yes. All right.
So we kind of want to just kind of jump in because, I mean, you were gracious enough to let us go to your studio and see your art and what you do. And we love it. We actually found him, Shay found him on
Instagram.
Instagram, the one and only.
Yes.
And when I saw his work immediately, I was like, Josh, you have to see this. And we were like, oh, should we ask him? What if he says no?
Yeah, we were worried that you were going to say no. Yeah. And we were like a little timid by it. But fortunately, you said yes.
Are. Yeah, and here we are.
Yeah, so getting right into it. How did you get into painting? Okay. Like, tell us why painting or your love for painting and how you got into it.
So, quick summary of how I got into it. I was working at this real estate company like 2-3 years back. And the first job he told me to do was go down to 23rd Street and walk into these buildings and see if anybody wants to move. So all those buildings were art galleries.
Okay.
And that was the first time I was introduced to art. And then since then, ideas sparked and I got some paint and I was painting on paper and garbage bags. Because you know, when you're ignorant at first, you don't know.
Right.
So I just tried that and I've been doing that ever since.
So you never, as a kid, you never drew a lot and like, painted a lot?
I did as much drawing and painting as like a regular
kid.
Regular kid would do. Yeah. If you go to class and they tell you, you know, today we're doing art class, that's the most drawing and painting that I ever did. So
really?
I was really a sports kid.
Oh, really?
Everybody that really knows me, I played sports, I played basketball. You know, soccer, football, things of this nature,
Gotcha.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Talk with your mom, though, when we met your mother at your gallery space or your studio space. I mean, she was telling us that your first 3 months of painting, you got a showing in London. I mean, that's an amazing experience.
It was insane. And I guess I kind of kudos to Instagram and, you know,
online
and digital world. But yeah, that's where that came from. I've been sharing my work ever since I started because I kind of wanted to document it or just see, like, I was like, why not? And I never felt any like attachment to it, so it was easier for me to just post and share the work, you know what I mean? And from there, I'm here sitting with you guys. You guys find me on Instagram as well. So,
were you nervous going to London and like showing your work? Because sometimes as an artist, it's like you have your work and then you know, you said you're not attached to it, but were you nervous to like share what you're working on with the world?
No,
oh, wow.
it's gonna sound bad, but I don't care
right.
in a way. Okay, here's a better way to put it. I'm really open to whatever.
Right.
So like if someone was to come into the art gallery today and say that was the worst piece I've ever seen,
yeah.
it was just like, okay, now I know.
So you do that? Like if you're angry, you literally like put your whole feeling whatever into the...
Uh-huh. Even if it's a figurative piece, you can still do it.
Like Shay said when we were at your gallery, you have these things with these eyes and we love this.
These layers. Like
yes.
there's so many layers to it because,
exactly.
yeah, like Jeff said, you have the double eyes and then, mm-hmm. you know, like I pointed out to you earlier, they were naked and it's like, what was the significance of that? That, I guess, to me, it meant like kind of being open,
being
yourself.
Open.
Yeah, being vulnerable.
Yeah, and then, exactly. And in a way, that's exactly what it is, you know?
Yeah.
Because like for me, think about it, as much as like the figures are open and naked, like me painting that as an artist, I'm the same way.
Right.
Because I leave myself open for criticism that way.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like,
that's true.
Yeah.
How do you name pieces like that? Because you have the Amber Room, you have a couple other that say Room. Why? Like, where do you come up with those names for a piece?
The same way I kind of come up with ideas is the same way. Because I used to write poetry before. I still do. Mm-hmm. Not as heavily now, but... So it's like a on the spot, on the moment kind of thing. It'll hit you.
Okay.
If I'm using a color, like, you know, if I'm in here and I'm painting something like this, I'll use the color in the piece, or a saying will come to mind that I was thinking about, and I just run with it. I don't know. I'm loose with it. I'm very loose with
so
it.
So you're very in the moment. Kind
very
of
in the moment. Very
like
in the moment.
Is it hard for you to have a piece and, like, is it hard for you to do a long series of painting? Like, you know, have a painting that you work on for, like, 6 months?
Yeah, absolutely. It's hard for me to go back to a piece. I'll paint for a day. And I don't know, it's hard. It's like,
cause you have to hold on to that thought.
You gotta
right?
hold on to that thought, or you gotta bring something new to it. I really just like to get it out on the canvas, and whatever it is, I like to leave it. If I come back in a week, in a month, and I feel like I could do something, then I will. But if not, you know, I leave it and I go on, I move on to the next one.
Do you have blank canvas fear? Sometimes, yeah. Like sometimes when you see this blank canvas, it's
intimidating.
Yeah.
With that, I think it's like an artist like ego thing, because you want to make something great.
Right.
But in reality, you just have to you got to let go of that, and you got to just do it, you know what I mean? If it comes out great, then, you know, it does. If not, you make another one, you know what I mean?
But, yeah, it's true.
Yeah,
no,
it's true. I feel like if I hold myself to an expectation, I was like, oh, I want to make something good, then I'll get blank canvas fear.
Yeah.
And I'll freeze up, and I can't make the first mark. But every single time that I've just made the first mark,
So just getting it down.
Yeah.
Put a line, like what's the
Absolute,
first mark? Is it like just like pencil?
It could be a line.
First?
It could be a line, it could be color. I'll just put like a block of color.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It could be a block of color line, and then I cover it all.
So
and
that's
start
how
over
you
again.
Conquer your blank fear thing almost.
Yeah.
Because like once you put that mark on there, you've broken that that space of having nothing.
Right. And then, you know, and then it's like, you really can't fail if you're painting, because it's painting. You can always cover it over with more layers.
So tell us your creative process on painting.
Like,
because it seems like if you're in the moment, you probably start at different things. Like some people always have to sketch first. Some people have like almost like a ritual. What are your rituals to get started on something?
Even going back to your inspiration, like how do you come up with an idea? And
oh,
then go from
okay. So I could tackle both of those. So the inspiration flat out just comes from like art history. Like I know a lot of art history. I'll always look back to other artists, Dali, Picasso, Chile, all these people, I know all of them.
That's great.
Yeah, so I know all of them. So it's like I can't really run out. If I don't have an original idea, I'll get inspired by somebody else and then I'll make it mine.
Yeah.
I have no shame in like going back to, or I'll find a contemporary artist too. There's a lot of living artists that I like. So there's that, and then as a ritual, sometimes I'll just sit in front of the piece, and that's how I kind of like, I could kind of visualize it a little bit to an extent, just to the point where I can start.
I get it.
And then when I can start, then I can go. Yeah.
The way that you use color, you're not afraid of it.
But see,
push it.
People that came before me, like I look at Basquiat, he was a crazy colorist.
Yeah.
I look at all the Impressionist era, all those people were crazy colorists. So all of that type of, I don't know, skill of it, that all comes from people before me, all of it. It's so funny, my professor said this to me. Certain things in your art will snitch on you. They'll tell on you. Like, you know, if you focus on something for a long time, it'll show.
Yeah.
Someone can try to like explain their art and say, you know, oh, well, this is what this means. But when somebody looks at it and they see, okay, well, the eyes are saying this, you know, the eyes are saying this. You know what I mean? That's what you focused on.
You are It always feels like you're giving a piece of yourself and everything.
Yeah, and life is dark. A lot happened, like a lot. Yeah. I try to find the beauty in that.
Right.
It's easy for me to paint something that's beautiful. I don't feel any connection to it. Because right now, in the space that I'm in right now, life is not, you know, it's getting there, it's beautiful, but it's not like, you know, so it's very real when you see.
What kind of advice or what things could you share with anybody that's inspiring to get into painting or any lessons that you would give them?
Yeah, my number one advice would be to educate yourself on all the artists, painters, creatives in general that came before you. Ocean of knowledge and inspiration, for sure.
Oh,
ocean.
So is there anything that, because you transitioned, like didn't just go right into art. Mm. So are there any things you learned along your journey? Because I'm sure it can be kind of scary to be on one path, then you're like, oh my gosh, I just discovered a new path. And
yeah, take that step, to take the step.
Because
I was I was in a place where I was fine. I could have been fine financially to, you know, take the step. If you really feel like, you know, you feel a passion or whatever it is, a calling to that place, just take the step. If it doesn't work, go back.
What does creator mean to you, or being a creator mean to you?
Being a creator means to be fully present. It's hard to do, very hard to do, but to be fully present. And then once you're able to do it, you know, you'll understand. Yeah, to be fully present.
I like that.
Shout outs to Creator Lifestyle. I'm Harris Lee Rose. If you want to check me out on Instagram, Harris Lee Rose. Website, Harris Lee Rose Art. TikTok, Harris Lee Rose Art. We go.
We would like to thank everybody from the bottom of our hearts. This is the wrap for season one for us.
Yes, it is.
We want to give a shout out to all the artists that we interviewed.
Wrap for season one.
Yes, and thank you to Harris. Harris, we appreciate you coming on the show, taking a chance on us, and thank you for being a part of making our vision and our dream come true with this episode especially. And can't wait to see all the things you're going to be doing. People, everybody stay tuned into Harris. Follow him, Harris Lee Rose. And remember,
it's more than art, it's life.
Imagine more.